ding dong, ding dong.
Hi everyone, lovely to be with you all again. It's day 13 of our Advent readings. I hope you've been enjoying them so far. And today, we're going to take a reading from the Jesus Storybook Bible again. And it's written by Sally Lloyd Jones. Our reading today is called The Warrior Leader. And it's a story about Joshua and the Battle of Jericho that you can also find in your Bible in the book of Joshua, chapter 3 and 6. After Moses died, God gave his people a new leader. His name was Joshua, which means the Lord saves. Joshua was going to lead God's people into the special land God had promised to give them. By this time, God's people had been wandering around in that baking desert for 40 years. So you can imagine how sick they were of sand and anything yellow, and tents, and walking, and being hot. And how happy they were to reach the edge of the desert and to see their beautiful new home right there in front of them, all cool and green and lovely. There was only one problem, Jericho. Jericho was a city, but it wasn't just any old city. It was a fortress, and it stopped anyone from getting into the land. The people looked at Jericho, at the big, giant, scary walls all around it, at the tall, towering ramparts, at the heavy iron gates bolted shut, at each other. Shall we have a look? And you see the huge towers and the ramparts and the big bolted gate. What would they do? No one knew, but God knew. And God told Joshua what to do. But Joshua must have looked surprised, because it was a very odd battle plan, as we'll soon find out. Then God made his people a promise. I will always be with you, and I will never, ever leave you. If you do what I say, your lives in the new land will be very happy, and everything will go well. So Joshua gathered his army together. They had their swords and spears and shields. They were ready to fight. But the plan wasn't about fighting. It was about trusting and doing what God said. Joshua's army went marching, marching, marching around the city, day after day after day. Can you try marching? I wonder how they would have marched around the city day after day. They're too scared to fight, the people in Jericho said. But they were wrong. God's people weren't scared. They were waiting for God to tell them what to do next. On the seventh day, God told his people to march around the city, not once, but seven times. Then God told everyone to make as much noise as they could. Has anyone ever told you to make as much noise as you can? Well, imagine that noise. Add 39,999 other people making that noise too, and you'll get the idea. Ear splitting. I certainly wouldn't want that noise in my house. And as it turned out, stone splitting too, because the huge, strong walls of Jericho just crumbled to the ground as if they were made of sand. Jericho vanished in a great cloud of dust. So it was that God's people entered their new home, and they did not have to fight to get in. They only had to walk. Joshua said, "God has brought you safely here. Now, will you do what he says?" Everyone said, "We promise." "Only God can make your heart happy," Joshua said, "so don't pray to pretend gods." "No," they said, "never." I'm afraid they didn't keep their promise. They didn't do what God said. And many years later, just as God warned them, things would go badly for God's people. They would lose their home. Enemies would capture them and take them off as slaves. And God's people would scatter into many different lands. But God's plan was still working. One day, he would give his people another leader and another home. But this home, no one could ever take from them. It does look beautiful, doesn't it? Can you see that? Very different from the desert they had been in for 40 years. That was the end of our reading for day 13. It's interesting, isn't it, how God's plans can be a little bit different to what we might expect. Sometimes we can think of doing something one way and think it's the only way of doing it, but God has a different idea and a different way. Thank you for listening today, and enjoy the rest of the readings. Before we go, I've got my bauble. Have you got yours? I wonder if you've decorated yet. Or maybe you could decorate it after. I'm now going to put it on the tree. Oh, we'll go for this branch here. There we go. Thank you all. Bye.